Hello friends, welcome to DB Tutorials. In this tutorial, let us learn how to use the schedule options calculate start to start lag option in Primavera P6. Let us create a sample project first in Primavera. Click on new project from the file option. Select EPS and click directly on this finish button. Now select the project, new project, and go to the project details tab and select the default calendar as 24/7 and the project plan start date as 23rd February 2020. Okay, now you can open the project, create three activities, activity A and then activity B and then activity C. Give 5 days as duration for all the three activities. And now set the relationships between A to B as finish to start and B to C as start to start with a lag of 2 days. Okay, now let us update the schedule as per the actual updates and consider 26th February as the data date. Now put the actual start date for activity A as 23rd February 2020 and put the actual start date of activity B as 25th February. That means it is running actually out of sequence because activity B should be starting only after the finish of activity A, but here it is starting before the finish of activity A. That means it is running out of sequence. Okay, now this feature of schedule option would be very useful in this type of cases. The start date of activity C will be determined depending on which option you are selecting as part of schedule options. Okay, now let us go to schedule options and see that early start has been selected by default. Okay, now click on this schedule button. Now the dates will be getting changed as activity B has started and 1 day has been passed away. We can say that the lag of 1 day has been expired already. And the activity C can now only start with the remaining lag of 1 day because original lag is 2 days and minus 1 has been expired. So remaining lag is 1 day. So activity C can start on Tuesday, that is 3rd March 2020. It is considering lag from the start of the remaining activity of B. Okay. Now let's see using the other option of actual start and click on schedule button to see that the dates change again. In this case, the lag duration is calculated from start actual start date of activity B. The lag is consumed on Tuesday and Wednesday. Okay, because the activity has started on Tuesday. So lag is consumed for Tuesday and Wednesday. Therefore, the start date of activity C will be Thursday, that is 27th February 2020, which is much earlier than our previous date of the early start option. Got it, friends? So in this way, you should be selecting the schedule options accordingly based on your requirements. So friends, this is all about the calculate start start lag option in Primavera P6 from the schedule options. Okay, so if you have enjoyed this tutorial, please give me a like, share and comment. For further more interesting videos, please do subscribe DB Tutorials. Thank you friends, thanks for watching.